Hey guys, what's going on today? My name is Celebrity, and I haven't done story times in a while. But I doubt any of you would care because of my subscriber count, but yeah. Today I got a story time for you that took place like a few weeks ago at Applebee's. So yeah. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the story time. Since we're still kind of new to the area here in Florida, because I already said this before on the channel, we're 2 months in now, but we moved from Washington to Florida, which like took us 7 days to do, and last month in February we had time to spare to do some fun out. To do some fun outings, which there is actually kind of more than there is in Washington. I don't know. Maybe it could just be me. Just saying that since I'm still new. But then we decided to stop for dinner because on our way back, and we chose Applebee's since that's like the only place we know. Right now, we're still like gonna get used to all the new places we don't know. But yeah. And so we get into the Applebee's we would usually go to. I've been th at this point th this was my fourth time at that Applebee's. Right? Or for the third? I actually don't know. No, it's my actually third time. I'm sorry. What did I say fourth? I've only been there for like 3 times. Anyway, we were talking about like everything we did that day and what we liked the most. And we were just kind of chatting a bit, and then some like little kid, he looked like either like 4 or 5. Well, we already got our drinks. I got myself a Mountain Dew. And my parents got like some kind of beer brand. And then yeah, so this little kid comes up, either like 4 or 5, from the table on the other side of us, because there's that wall on the outer part of Applebee's. So yeah, he went over like, "Hi," and we just all looked at the kid going like, "Hi." And like, kid, can you not right now? That it's kind of weird. The kid actually listened to me and went back over to sit down. His parents probably brought him down from there anyway. So, and I think I did actually see them walk in. I don't actually really know. I mean, I was facing the outside door. But yeah. Then the kid just looked over us again and like, can you just not please? Then went back down again. We go back into talking. Kid comes up again and I'm just like, this, what's up with the kid? Is he 100% extrovert and 0% introvert. I don't know what's this kid. And then out of nowhere, he literally sticks his whole hand into my mom's beer cup, and we're just the kid, what the hell, kid? Just we're and my dad already has the old parenting skills, so he kind of listened to him well. It was just so weird. Like, even my mom used to work at Applebee's in the ni back in the 90s. And she never experienced something like that at all in her life. It just got crazy. Like, I couldn't even stop thinking about it. It was that crazy. But then the kid's parents were like going like, "Oh, sorry about that. We're still trying to teach him manners and stuff." But I don't think it even happened to them. Even the tone of their voice were even telling me that this never happened to them before with their kid. The waiter comes by and says, "Can I help you guys with anything?" And we literally had to explain to him, like, what happened. So, gives my mom a new beer and stuff so that there isn't a child's germ in it. But then, by the time that she got a new one, I literally can see the parents actually leaving with a child. And it didn't seem like that they were there for long since, you know, if you were actually listening to the story, you would probably hear me say they walked in. I saw them walk in, then walk out just like that. Just like that. And the only thing I could ever think of was like what the kid will be looking back at this 12 years later. I think he might just be cringing a lot and never stop talking about other kids what he just did. And I still even have one of those too. Like when I was like 5 years old, or three or five, I don't actually remember. I snuck a crayon. Why did I say camera? Crayons and cameras are entirely different things. I stuck a crayon into the men's bathroom at IHOP and drew a big M. But also those crayons that IHOP has, they're actually washables. You can like wash them off easily if they ever get all the stuff. I wish my parents got one of those for me, because I remember I turned one wall in my bedroom a long time ago, an art wall. I like just drew all over that wall with crayons for like a year and a half. But then I stopped, of course. I'm not so sure why I did that, but at least it still stayed there until we moved. At least we still got to keep it. There was also a point when I did actually try to erase crayon marks on a wall with hand soap, with the pump and stuff, and water, but nothing came off. I'm starting to think, though, that I'm not using the right kind of soap. Obviously, I'm not. And now, I know for a fact that none of you guys are laughing at this. I'm laughing at my own joke. None of you are laughing at my jokes. I'm very sad now. Now on to Scrubby making a video like this. Okay, but unfortunately, I couldn't get him on. I still have 28 subscribers. I am making no progress whatsoever. You can't even hear me with this quiet voice, can you?
Well, turn up your volume!
Well, anyway, guys, I hope you guys like the video. Like if you like the video, subscribe if you're new, and dislike the video if you don't like it, because I'm not in charge of you. Also, comment below if you want to. I never said that before, but anyway, goodbye.